eating disorder, so I had anorexia. I was maybe like 28 kilos, it cost almost my life, this illness, and I overcame it without any help. No doctors, no psychologists, nobody. So what I want to say is that the feeling of embracing and celebrating the feeling of insecurity and uncertainty, and also the feeling of necessity, or how can I say, could be also your really great start in your entrepreneurship. And it's also entrepreneurship is a life school, and if you have experienced such drama things, they somehow form your personality, but then you also learn to redefine yourself anew, and you also to empower yourself, because you know your strength, and your strength is not because of your achievements or knows. So the other thing, another challenge was that when I came to Germany, I also didn't have any money for my parents. So the borders were closed. It was after the war in Europe fell, but it was in this post-communistic time between the European Union and... So it was very hard for people from Europe. Only the intellectual people could survive somehow, and I also had to do five jobs at the same time, because I studied art history and philosophy and archaeology. I graduated, and then I also started cultural management, because I realized that I really can't survive from this breadless art. What can I say? Now I realized, looking back, that it wasn't necessary to study these academic things, because I'm an artist. And to study art history and being an artist is a completely different thing. So it's still a luxury thing. So the people who are in this field are girls from rich families, or they have a rich man. And people have these cliché and prejudices in their mind. And when I say I'm from Eastern Europe, they also have their concept. She wants to marry a rich man to get a German passport, you know. But I was struggling 13 years to get a double citizenship as a person from the European Union. And when I started my gallery, I moved to a concept store in a big concept mall where the rent was $3,500 per month, you know, for 39 square meters. So imagine how much you should sell in order to earn your rent. Because I didn't have money, I had to earn money, so I started taking money from the people involved and just saying, okay, then you should participate. If you don't want it, then I don't exhibit your stuff. I found many people to do this, but I realized that the customer doesn't buy this because it's too expensive. So this was the one thing, and the other thing was this interdisciplinary mix of art and design, which is in a German mentality not really, it's very hard to... They have these boxes, you know, they only want to see contemporary art or contemporary design or only fashion. And my store was looking like a bazaar, so people were browsing there and it was very vivid. So I'm finishing.
You have a minute.
Sorry?
You have a minute.
Okay, a minute, okay. And the last thing is that there's no cultural funding for cultural entrepreneurships if you're not an NGO. I'm not an NGO, I want to earn money with what I'm doing, and this is means too commercial. So, there is a lot of bureaucracy, and not really, that's why I really decided to do it on my own, without any funding, without any bank, without investor, without business angel, only with a little saving, that's all. And it works, but it's very hard.
Okay, thanks so much, Kathy. And it seems to me like